If you want to warp this one, this one is always fun. Like, I use this so many times.
Oh wait, what did you? I just missed it. You just did a warp. I looked down at the chat. That was awesome. Do it again. Do it again. All right, welcome everybody. Good to see you again. So happy you're here, and I'm happy Rick is here. Rik Oostenbroek, if I'm saying your name correctly, can you just correctly like tell me how you say it so much cooler?
Dude, you killed it. It's Rik Oostenbroek, which is translates into Eastern pants in English. So
Eastern pants.
Eastern pants or pants from the East. Like, I don't know.
I don't know. All I know is you create awesome work, and I'm so happy that you are here.
Thanks, man. So when you got like this one, you want to create the outlines just to change it a bit. For instance, I'll keep this as a reference how it was. For instance, the C, it feels kind of weird to me. So what I want to do with that one, like I want to align it more with the O, which feels more like unified, like an actual circle. And I don't like how this is cut up. Oh, that's like, I'm not using Illustrator too often just for this kind of stuff. So I want the O to be exactly like round, kind of centered, and use my Pathfinder to eliminate that one. And then I'll get rid of the original one. Oh, look at that. And right now it's perfectly round. I don't know if this is a usual way of doing this.
Yeah, well, I assumed they were perfectly round to begin with, but I like.
No, but apparently, regarding the C, like the contrast in between those two for me is a bit too big. So I use my round O, this one, as a reference to create the C as well. I know, like, I'm not a typographer, so please shoot me if you don't like it. So how are we gonna do this?
How are we gonna do it?
No. Maybe a bit thinner.
Yeah, that could work. I like that.
Boom.
Jan Eric's, I'll just ask or answer these questions too, but can we edit fonts the same way in Photoshop? Like Rik, you're doing it exactly the right way. Just do this in Illustrator.
Thanks. Yeah, I think it's more flexible, and also totally. with the corner, I know they edited in Photoshop as well. I forgot to mention that I'm like a pre-release tester for Photoshop too. So they recently added this feature to like square like objects, which I like, but I simply like to tweak it this way. Plus you can go on like really deep into it. Like I like that. And that's just like, I don't know. This is the only reason that I learned Illustrator actually, like to mess with fonts and stuff like that. So I don't know. I find it interesting, like how other people do it. Because you always have like the Illustrator people and the Photoshop people.
Yeah, and I think you should just be both of those people.
Yeah, but that's not easy. Like I mean it's when you are a football or soccer player, like you always have one stronger foot, right? It's rare to have like you're good with left and right.
Yeah.
Well, I think so. I don't know if you're into soccer, but I am.
Yeah, no, I like you are right. Like the best tool for the job is going to be the tool you know, which might be Illustrator or Photoshop. But what's the word I'm looking for? Objectively, there is an answer to that question, the best tool for the job.
It's nice to know like different softwares so you can express yourself in different ways. That's always like my motivation. Like the ultimate goal is to reach creative freedom where you're able to create everything you want to create. So what we do, we pass our smart object over here. And we see right now we have a black layer, which is not good, actually. Like I never work with black, secret number one about my work. I never work with black. And right now, the reason why I did this was because I use a clipping mask for everything. Like clipping mask is my go-to tool. I don't know, like, and that way, like, we can... Wait, yeah, that way, okay. Let's make it nice gray, like a neutral color is good to make the colors pop in the end. Right now, yeah, you still have control over like the background color, and we can always like draw shapes over it once we want shapes over it. But right now I'm going the easy way, and that way like I can do the same over here.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. There we go. Boom. And
You might have deleted it. I don't know.
Create a clipping mask.
There we go.
Okay, and those cards aren't final, but that way you can have multiple layers of forms over each other and still like work within the typography, and you don't need to clip it over it. I don't know if this is like...
No, this is great. This is exactly why we have you on, just to see different, you know, ways of working. And this totally makes sense because your canvas are like the letters or your canvas.
Yeah, exactly.
You get to just paint inside of them unrestricted.
Word. And without limits. And especially like when we go a little bit further for coloring, like I can easily just focus on this shape. And without like affecting the rest, you know, like that. Yeah.
Very but yeah, cool. This,
okay.
And since you're selecting colors right now, somebody asks, Kevin does, about how do you recommend selecting colors? Like, how do you go about selecting colors?
You mean like how to pick a certain color?
Yeah. How did you end up with that sort of teal, like gray, the dark grayish purpley?
I don't know. It's a gut feeling. Like, no, but for instance, everybody has a different taste, of course. For me, like the colors in my work come together like super organically. I simply like those colors, and not necessarily to wear them as clothes or to hang up in my house, but to work with them. For instance, I never did an actual black and white thing. Like I can do it right now, but if it would be like this, I'll get restless. But some people might actually like to work in black and white. So for me, it kind of reflects the taste you have. Like you find, like you observe the world, especially if you're a visual artist or an illustrator or whatever, like you're always looking for things you like. And for me, that's the thing with colors. I really like some colors and I really don't like some, don't like other colors. And for instance, that's like, with black makes it super aggressive, actually. Okay, the word color doesn't like, that's, for me, it's just like a gut feeling I trust upon. I got my brush over here, which is set to a neutral gray right now. And I need to move it on top of my clipping mask stuff. So we're focusing on this layer, like the yellow, purple to bluish layer. What I want to try is to bring this more to life. So what I do, I got my layer over here. It's layer 15. Like, wait a second. I delete all empty layers just for cleaning purpose. I love that, like cleaning all empty layers. Okay, so here's my new layer. What I do, like I pick out a soft brush over here. My favorite one is usually the soft round pressure opacity, which is like a legacy OG Photoshop brush. It's been there since day one, I guess, or at least since day one I work. So what I do, like I put this layer style on multiply, and remember we're just like focusing on these for now. I always like to figure out like what would be the best way to tackle this depth, like create some fake sort of depth, like so where would our light source be? What would be the top layer? I think like ideally like what I want, is there a sun shape in here or something like that? Or well, there's an arrow. Okay, so light is coming from here. Just so you know, like if you're brushing in like all those shadow layers randomly, it would be a mess. So how would that react on this color shape? It's just by brushing all that stuff in. Where you get some sort of like, see, it's tricky. That's R thing with the R edges. Let's see. Now it's there. It's under it.
I like it.
And sometimes you have to like clean it up a little bit by this eraser tool. I don't know why I'm using that over masks, but it's just like where I'm used to a lot. So that way, with just a simple gray, like I think it's the same one I use. Oh, no, it's quite a bright gray.
Yeah, since you're painting on the same layer, you can always darken it and lighten it. And
that's it. So what, like, I'll do this usually as a highlight, so I'll do that later on as well, but it's just like, because he's asking it. So I got my orange pot over here. What I'm gonna do is like, you can do this two ways. Like, I'll do it the easiest way, by the way. Let me duplicate this layer, size it down. Crank up the lightness a bit. Got immerse these together. So right now, immerse these. I always like make a copy out of that, hide it, just to make sure I can move back to it. So if you want to warp this one is always fun. Like, I use this so many times.
Oh wait, what did you? I just missed it. You just did a warp. I looked down.
Sorry.
That was awesome. Do it again.
I'll do it again.
Okay. I got this part. Now
I got my layer over here. So right now, like, I warp it in a, like, let's say a
circle. Warp.
So it
would then grab the middle and then pull it to the edge. Oh.
Yes.
That's awesome.
And then let's focus on this bottom layer. This is a blue one. I copy paste it. Let's go to the blue one. And it looks like a actual kind of highlight.
Oh, that's cool.
And you can use this as many times as you want, like all over. It gets a little bit hectic once you put it over every shape, but it gives some sort of sense of depth.
For sure. That's the best use of the warp tool that I've ever seen.
Oh, really?
Literally click, drag, you have a highlight. It's really cool.
Boom.
Show this like full screen in all its glory. I love what you got going on here, baby. It looks awesome. And everybody says like, yeah, it looks like, Rob's like, yeah, it looks like candy.
We're not there yet.
It's looking great. Rik, you're a quality guy. I just want to thank you so much for hanging out with us.
Thank you, man. Thank you. No, it was fun.
Chill, and I just want you to do this all the time now.